demonstration of the hat champ and the different types of hats it will do. The sweatband first is pulled down, and there's aluminum stop on the back underneath the platen. The points of the bill on each side goes up against the stops. Just push the back of the bill up against the stops, pull up on the button at the sewn dimple area, push that right over the top of the point of the platen. Tuck the hat in underneath the platen, pull the gripper bar up and forward with enough force so it's underneath the platen. Then magnetic catch will hold it down. The important thing about loading the hats is the sewn dimple area right there to go over the top. On the foam caps, they're very simple to get over the top. It doesn't take any pressure at all because the foam will stretch so easily. On the poplin caps, it's a little harder. Now we're going to do a hat a little more difficult. Spread a little tack on the back of the foam. Place it on the platen. This particular hat has the buckram that is like a flap underneath the print area. First we'll load it with the buckram underneath the material. Loads the same way as the foam cap. Push it over the top. But on this you want to make sure you get all the dimple over the top of the platen. Tuck the cap underneath. Pull the gripper bar so it goes underneath the platen. And that foam makes a nice smooth print area. Now again, with the buckram out, while you're loading the cap, you have to keep pressure on this point so the material doesn't slide back down the center. There you go. Now we'll demonstrate probably the hardest hat it is to print on. We'll take this higher platen off. Put it on the low profile platen. This particular hat has a fused buckram glued right to the back of the print area. It's fairly stiff. It's going to take more pressure over the top of the platen. Loads the same way. But again, we have a flat surface to print on. Go over that again. Bring the sweatband down. Push the back of the points of the bill up against the aluminum stops. Pull up on the button. Push the sewn dimple area over the point. Pull up on the gripper bar. You're ready to print. Plastic. Now there's another hat that's difficult to do. We'll take this platen off. Take the platen off, you just simply just turn the screws underneath. Put this platen on, has a slight groove sanded in the rubber. Turn the thumb screws back on. This hat has a seam up through the center. Now that seam is a little thicker than the material. So with this groove cut in here, the seam will sit right down the groove. The hat loads the same way. There's no dimple area though. So you simply just put your finger and pull the top of the hat over the top of the plantain and tuck it in. Pull the grip bar up underneath and down. Now that seam will sink down in that groove and you'll be able to do the 6-panel caps. Now we'll demonstrate the visor. We'll take off this plantain and put the smallest one on. It measures only 2 inches from the top to the bottom. Now we're going to utilize the piece of plastic in the front. We're going to put the bill underneath the plastic. For the plantain to work with this visor, the visor has to be about 3 inches tall. You pull the visor top over the top of the plantain. You catch the edge of the top of the visor with the gripper bar. Holds it down enough to do your printing. The shorter visors that are lower will not work with this hat champ. Now, an easy way to test the hat, see how much pressure it takes. So you have a flat, straight print, is load a hat. And don't put any print on it, just take a piece of masking tape and put it straight across the print area, about 1/4 inch wide, about 6 inches long. Unload the hat. Look at the masking tape. If the masking tape is straight without any frown, you've put enough material over the top of the plantain right there. If you have a frown, then you want to reload the hat with a little more pressure over the top of the plantain. A little more material over the top. Take your tape off, put it back on, then check the hat for the second time until you've eliminated the frown or any tilt. Each hat, there are two adjustments on the hat champ. One is the metal bar underneath the plantain that is spring loaded. By turning this left knob counterclockwise, the metal bar comes out forward. And what that does, the point of the bill, when it goes up against the metal bar, will leave the hat at a slight angle, which will bring more material up over the top of the plantain, so your print will be a little bit lower on the left. So if you have a hat print that is always tilted down on one side, you can adjust the metal bar underneath to adjust the tilt of your print. Now the other adjustment, and some hats you'll probably want to load this way, is with a bill underneath the plastic. Loads the same way, except that when the bill's underneath the plastic, you have to put maybe just a little bit more pressure over the top of the plantain and get that material over it.